अस्सलामुअलैकुम, वेलकम टू द आफिया सलाम शो। और आज इस शो पे मेरे साथ एक बहुत दिलचस्प शख्सियत है, इनका नाम है सरमद तारिक। वेलकम सरमद।
थैंक यू।
सरमद तारिक का एक मुख्तसर सा तारुफ ये है कि ये एक मोटिवेशनल स्पीकर हैं और बहुत अच्छी अच्छी बातें लोगों को बताते हैं, अपने तजर्बात से लोगों को मोटिवेट करते हैं। ज़िंदगी के बहुत से चैलेंजेस का इन्होंने सामना किया है और उन पर उबूर के हासिल किया है। उसके अलावा इनको लिखने का भी बहुत शौक है, ये ब्लॉग अपना एक मेंटेन करते हैं। और इनके एक, ये बहुत क्रिएटिव आदमी हैं और इन्होंने अपने लिए एक गैबी दोस्त बना लिया था और उस गैबी दोस्त का नाम था
शंटू।
शंटू, उस शंटू के साथ इनका काफ़ी टाइम गुजरता है और शंटू के साथ वो बातें कर लेते हैं जो कि वो दूसरों के साथ नहीं कर पाते, या शंटू से इनको वो जवाब ये अक्स करवा लेते हैं जो कि ये चाहते हैं कि दूसरे लोगों से इनके मिले। क्या ख्याल है, नहीं सही है?
कुछ ऐसा ही है, कुछ ऐसा ही है जी।
अच्छा, जब शंटू से इनकी काफी बातें हो गई तो इन्होंने फिर सोचा कि एक किताब लिख लें, ऐसे ही हुआ?
असल में शंटू जो था वो है रादर, शंटू इज अ वेरी वेरी डियर फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन, आप उसको इमेजिनरी कहें या रियल कहें, फॉर मी ही इज पार्ट ऑफ माई रियलिटी बिकॉज मेरी किताब पे भी उसका नाम छपा और सारी चीज है। एंड ही इज, जो उसका एग्जैक्ट टाइटल मैंने उसे दिया हुआ है वो मैं कैमरा के आगे बोल नहीं सकता, बट ही इज वन ऑफ दोज पीपल जो कि आपके मुंह पे मारेगा जो भी बात उसके जहन में होगी। तो अगर आप उसके घर गए और वो आपसे मिलना नहीं चाहता तो आप बेल बजाएंगे, दरवाजा खोलेगा कि आपको मिलना नहीं चाहता मैं, आप पूछेंगे आप मसरूफ हैं तो वो कहेगा नहीं मैं कुछ नहीं कर रहा, टीवी देख रहा हूँ, बट मैं आपको नहीं मिलना चाहता।
Okay.
तो आप कल आए। तो हम लोग आई थिंक सोसाइटी की रट में और सोसाइटी के रिचुअल्स में इतना ज्यादा बॉक डाउन हो गए कि एट टाइम्स वी फॉरगेट के इम्पोर्टेंट चीजें क्या हैं और लेस इम्पोर्टेंट चीजें क्या हैं
और अपने लिए इम्पोर्टेंट क्या है।
मतलब हम लोग सोसाइटी की प्रायोरिटीज पे चलते हैं एज अपोज टू अपनी प्रायोरिटीज पे। तो वो एक बड़ा क्रिटिकल एलिमेंट है जो कि हर एक की जिंदगी में पर्सनल टाइम, पर्सनल स्पेस, पर्सनल वैल्यूज, उन सबको सेवर करने के लिए, नॉट बीइंग आउट देयर टू चेंज द वर्ल्ड एंड चेंज द सिस्टम एंड यू नो बीइंग वेरी अग्रेसिव अबाउट इट। सो शंटू इज बेसिकली ही इज अ वेरी लेट बैक पर्सन, ही ऑब्जर्व थिंग्स एंड देन ही you know just blurts out whatever,
but he is very comfortable in his own skin.
He is, he is very secure. Yes. He does not have any you know social kya usse kehna chahiye, pressure associated to him. Kuch usne badtameezi kar kar ke logon ko turn off kar diya hua hai, kuch generally turned off hai usse uski baatein sunne ki wajah se. So you know he is a very happy
but
man,
but he is okay with that.
He is very happy, he is very happy, and he and I have a very good time whenever we sit together, and that is how the book happened, you know. And it was you know jo the story goes के उसकी शंटू ने लिखी थी, इट वॉज अबाउट अ कैरेक्टर विच वॉज नॉट शंटू हिमसेल्फ, बट इंटेंट उसके बीच में जो मेरी इंटरप्रिटेशन है, इट इज मोर लेस दैट यू नो वी लाइक टू मेक फन ऑफ लूजर्स, यू नो जो भी जिंदगी में थोड़े से वियर्ड हैं या पीछे रह गए हैं
या मुख्तलिफ हैं,
या हमसे मुख्तलिफ हैं, उनका मजाक उड़ाने में हमें बहुत मजा आता है। उसी प्रेमाइस को लेते हुए आप अगर एक बंदा है बिल जो इसमें लीड कैरेक्टर है नेचुरल गैसेस का जो बुक का पोर्शन है,
कैन आई जस्ट कट यू हियर, नेचुरल गैसेस, व्हाट अ टाइटल एंड व्हाई,
उसमें
मे आई जस्ट शो द बुक देयर फर्स्ट एंड कैन यू जस्ट प्लीज एनलाइटन अस के व्हाई नेचुरल गैसेस।
Natural gases, I don't you think it's catchy? I think it's catchy.
It's catchy. It's extremely embarrassing to explain.
No, it could be about minerals also, but it just
but
depends
it
on what you
but
think, where you're coming from.
I'm coming from this, and here it doesn't talk of minerals.
Yes, it does not. It does not. But
so
natural, natural gases that we produce, and they do at times have a very grave effect on our lives. Natural gases and the beginning of the book and the sarcasm in the book does not primarily highlight you know the obscenities. It basically you know, gives it a very light feeling while touching upon very critical human behavior elements or social elements or emotional elements.
And actually, what you've written in this book, जो शुरू में ही आपने कहा है कि I don't know why this book was written and I don't know where it is going. So, I mean, that's a very different way of embarking on a project of writing a book. This is not a blog. This is a time-consuming and a planned process. कि book अगर लिख रहे हैं तो आप उसको print करने की भी नियत से लिख रहे होंगे. प्रिंटिंग के नजरिए से एक चीज को लिखना, फिर उसकी प्रेजेंटेशन, फिर उसकी जाहिर है कोई ना कोई आप चाहते होंगे जब बुक लिखी है तो लोग पढ़ें, तो उसकी कोई मार्केटिंग का एलिमेंट होगा जहन में. तो इफ यू डिडंट नो व्हाट यू वर गोइंग टू राइट अबाउट एंड वेयर यू वर गोइंग, हाउ डिड दिस बुक गेट कंप्लीट?
देखिए, आप जो बातें कर रही है ना वो ये है कि इस किताब से मैं पैसे कैसे बनाऊंगा.
नहीं, लोगों तक कैसे पहुंचाएंगे,
लोगों तक कैसे पहुंचाऊंगा, या मतलब
बेसिकली
वो मसले जो लोगों के,
अच्छा ठीक है,
ये वो मसाइल हैं जो मेरे नहीं है, वो लोगों के हैं. मेरा काम था, मेरा दिल की एक किताब लिखने को मैंने लिख दी. कुछ लोगों को पढ़ाई, अच्छा फीडबैक आया तो उसको मैंने पब्लिशिंग के लिए डाल दिया. आई डिडंट हैव एनफ मनी टू डू इट, एक दो इन्वेस्टर मिल गए, उन्होंने कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट कर दिया. देन आई स्पोक टू द डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स, हर जगह रखवा दी और उसमें भी बहुत लोगों ने आके असिस्ट कर दिया. अब आगे ये लोग खरीदते हैं या नहीं खरीदते, दैट अगेन इज वॉज नॉट द इंटेंशन बिहाइंड द बुक. इफ पीपल बाय इट एंड रीड इट, इट वुड बी गुड, बट अदरवाइज यू नो, इफ यू कॉल इट, अगर मैं इसको प्रैक्टिकल साइट पे या सो कॉल्ड हमारी सोशल उस साइट पे ले जाओ, तो यस, इट डज गिव मी अ प्रोफाइल क्रेडिट दैट आई एम ऑथर ऑफ अ पब्लिश्ड बुक, बट इट वाजंट मेंट फॉर दैट, बिकॉज इस किताब को पढ़ के अगर मेरा प्रोफाइल जो बनेगा और जिस तरह आप बता रही हैं टाइटल्स और बाकी सारी चीजों से, वो कोई इतना इंप्रेसिव नहीं होगा कि आई वुड बी एबल टू एक्सप्लॉइट इट मच. बट अगेन आई वुड स्ट्रेस दैट इट इज नॉट ऑल फन एंड गेम्स, इट इज नॉट अबाउट यू नो, it is about actual emotions and real life and real scenarios that happens not only to Bill in this book but in everybody's life in one way or the other.
When some other character reveals himself or herself, that revelation is painful to Bill or it's confusing to Bill.
Exactly.
So ye to hamari puri zindagi mein isi tarah,
and then you know hamari matlab why do parents do what they do, you know, there's so many elements. There's in a very concise novel-y size of a book, it does cover a lot of issues. It does cover, which can become very overwhelming also. And at the same time, you know, there are to make it easier, I divided it into two segments. One is the novel, which is called Natural Gases by Shantu. And then the other part is that my conversations with Shantu. And that again touches a lot upon Pakistani society, human behavior, and then the social pressures that we take upon ourselves and fret about and expend our energy.
So basically your conversations with Shantu, which are there in your blog?
Yeah, not on my blog.
Not on your blog.
Not on my blog.
Okay. So but then since you have taken it and you say that it touches upon social issues and societal issues, etc., is there an autobiographical touch in this? Because usually a writer's first book somehow has the imprint of the writer on it. Would you say it would reflect yourself?
Not at all. The story does not reflect me at all.
So you were standing on the outside and looking in and writing the story about other characters.
Exactly.
You were not there somewhere in the middle. Not even came your role. You have to find you something.
I think that once you get to read it, maybe you can. I would not spoil it for them.
No. I mean, when you start writing.
Obviously,
you
know, it has to come from somewhere within.
Yeah.
It cannot be totally out. It has to be somewhere from within.
From your own experiences, from your own.
Or something that you have observed in life, or something that irritates you, or something that. So, you know, those elements are obviously there, but there's no way that I'm being portrayed in my, you know, my
life. No, I didn't mean that you would be the protagonist. You're not.
Yeah.
But the writer is reflected somewhere in the writing, especially in the first novel. That is what generally I've seen writers also say the first time, because it's there from the heart, whatever they've experienced and observed, they put it there.
Yeah.
Maybe in a third person through another character. But those are your observations, not just that character's observations.
Yes, in that sense, definitely. There's a lot of my observation and, you know, what I've learned in life and things that I... And then, obviously, you have to also complement the fact that how to make it interesting for readers.
Absolutely.
For example, I have left many things vague in it for readers' imagination. And a lot of people have asked me to fill in the scenery and setting. And I did not pay attention to those aspects at all. That is a negative in terms of people who are voracious readers and regular readers. But at the same time, you know, it's a different style of writing also. And as we know that reading is a dying art and writing is a dying art, I wanted it to be very, you know, punchy and a very, I think punchy would be the right word. Not too lingery or not too, you know, drag.
You wanted your own space within the writers and you think that this kind of style...
I think it's a different... It's different.
Because it is different, it would be more noticeable or it would be... You know, it would be different from what the other writers are putting
It's an easy read. It's an easy read. For somebody like most of the people I see who do not read, it would be easy for them to read also.
Actually, those are the audiences that need to be brought on to the other side.
Yeah.
You know, those who have gone on to the dark side, they need to be brought on here.
Exactly.
Because like you said, reading is a dying art. But writing actually is not all that bad. You know, Pakistani writers are making their mark in the world. Urdu and English, both.
They are. But I don't know, maybe I did not know the right path or it was my impatience or something. But publishing, getting a good publisher and then distribution, both of them are very, very difficult for people. I shouldn't call it a cult, but there's a group of people who's in this industry. And till the time you break into that group, you will not get... You know, you will not get a writer's credit. For example, if I put my book in a shop and they take 50% off the retail price.
They usually do.
And when you talk to them, what a joke. So they say, sir, you will also be in 200-250 rupees. So you will also be margin in the point is that bikne mein to margin hota hai, but the content which is in the book, due to which it sells, that has no value.
No, it doesn't. Actually, that unfortunately, the creative jo output hai, that is not really quantifiable or it should be. In some form, at least it should get some kind of credit. But this is true for everybody. All writers complain of the same thing. All people in the creative arts complain of the same thing.
Yeah.
So I guess you're not alone in that.
Yeah, I think there again, in writing, what I've heard and learned so far is again that ironically, we do have the India route. You know, authors go there and then they make it big and then they come back to Pakistan and then they are taken.
Well, and not just that, not just make it big, it's actually because of the economies of scale. Because their market is such that you can publish a larger number of books, which brings down the cost of publishing. And in Pakistan, how many books can a writer publish? Well, they'll probably say, ji, 500 chapte hain, to 500 astronomical cost ho jati hai. Ek us writer ke liye, jo ki is business mein
nahi hai,
jisne ek shaukiya kitab nikali hai, uske liye Pakistan mein kitabein chapna.
It is not shaukiya. I would not like to put natural guesses in the category.
No, I mean, they're not professional writer. You wouldn't earn, or would you want to earn your keep through writing books?
I would definitely, maybe, you know, for example, like in my case, I evolved. I've evolved with my life. When I had my accident, I educated myself. I worked hard for, you know, my financial stability. And then I could travel a lot. I could do marathons. I did that. Now that I'm physically very confined and my movement is very low, writing is an avenue which I can do sitting at home and, you know, without any external help, voice recognition software being, I can barely type with my knuckles also. So if I at some point you know, I think the issue with me is primarily to stabilize myself, to find right. out what I want to do consistently. And there is nothing that I do consistently.
Is it because you don't want to, that you're not, you know, hardwired that way? You enjoy going from one to another?
Like, even in writing, you know, Shantu was one thing, Shantu articles were one thing, then, you know, there's some other things happened, and, you know, I had this alien series going on my blog for quite some time. Then there are, you know, social issues. So I do, even in my writing, I do whatever I feel like.
You know, I meant because you've done, you know, met and surmounted so many challenges, physical as well as obviously social, and I'm sure there must have been psychological, emotional challenges.
Obviously.
So you've not really stayed on one path. You've done a lot of different things, and you've proved yourself good at them. So in writing, now, is this where you're looking for consistency? Won't you get bored?
I might. But one thing that I'm trying to do is to keep regular on it. And, you know, it gives me a good opportunity to put my thoughts across, vent a little also. Mm. But money-making-wise, I would love to make money out of writing, because it's not easy, but, you know, it's a very good way of making money. But I don't see it happening in the near future, at least. But I will do another book.
But you'll keep at it.
I'll keep at it, well, definitely. I was telling somebody before coming in that I have that narcissistic personality. So anything that gives me, you know, attention and mileage, I would do. I've been an athlete for quite some time. I've done a book. Now maybe do a music album next, and then, you know.
That's what I meant. you may just get bored of this.
You never know. I cannot promise you that.
Well, we wish you the best in whatever you want to do.
Thank you so much.
You've excelled in whatever you've tried your hand at.
Thank you.
So all the best, and thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you very much, and see you next time on the Afia Salam show. And to learn more about it, please visit our website, 247.tv.